Hey, welcome back to our period of study this morning in prayer together. We're at Philippians chapter 2, and we're going to look at verses 12 and 13 this morning. Let's read them. Therefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling, for it is God who works in you both to will and to do for his good pleasure. Now, this contains some theologically forbidden words. Paul got it all wrong. Of course, he didn't, but you would think so by the way some people portray the teaching of Scripture. Indeed, what we have here is, let's look at verse 12 and then 13. He's talking to the Philippian church, believers in Jesus in the Philippian church, and he says, look, I know that you've obeyed. I know that when I wasn't there, you were still following Jesus and you're still following God's ways. I know that. But as you did that, he says even more, now much more in my absence. I'm not with you anymore. We planted this church. Now may you just come up higher. Let's you and I just both keep coming up higher. Even more, he says, and then he uses this terrible word, work. We can't use that word. Somebody needs to talk to Paul and get this corrected before this gets into print somewhere and confuses people. This is the Greek word ergon, and it's that word work. And it's a good word in the Bible. It's not a bad word. It's a good word. We're not saved by our own works. That's very clear from Scripture. But the concept of being actively engaged in living the Christian life is a good thing. It's not a bad thing. It's the Bible's not against it. It's for it. And he says here, so now I want you to do this. Work out your own salvation. There's a sense in which we do have a part, isn't there? Isn't there? Come on, let's be fair about this. Work out your own salvation. This is the words of the Apostle Paul. We each have a personal responsibility to be engaged, to be acting out our faith, to be actively doing it. The word work is actually used. Work out your own salvation, but it didn't stop there. Do it with fear and trembling. There's a spirit we should have, a spirit of respect and awe and actual caution, because if we get this wrong, we're going to send the wrong message about who Jesus is. Verse 13, for, before or because, that's the Greek conjunction. It can be translated either way. For or therefore, because it is God who works in you. Who's working in me? God is working in me. So there's that word work again, that nasty word. We're not supposed to look at that word, but there it is. It just keeps popping up. Let there be a work done in me. There's a part that I have, a cooperative part. It doesn't earn me any credit, doesn't earn me any merit. I'm not saved by anything I do, right? But God works in me. And what's the result of that? It is God who works in you, both to will and to do for his good pleasure. So God has a purpose, God has a plan, and he wants to work in me to will and to act, to do according to his good pleasure. His good pleasure is for me to grow as a Christian. Let's be honest, we're all babies. We're infant children. We're infant Christians, and we need to come up higher. God has a purpose. He wants to use us. We just haven't gotten to the level where he can do the biggest things yet. So we want to let him work in us because that's what he wants to do. And whenever God says, I'm calling you to work, well, our first answer is yes. Our first answer is, yes, Lord, just tell me what to do. Let's go straight to it. Yes, Lord. I mean, it's immediately. Whatever God says, yes. There's a cooperative part. All the credit, all the salvation's from him. All the glory is to him. None for me, but we can reflect the truth of the Christian experience out into our world by living it out, doing it. And that's exactly what we're supposed to do in these verses based on the incarnation of Jesus we've been reading about morning by morning as we've been coming through to this spot. Oh, I hope you're blessed by this. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, Christianity is not a passive sport. This is not an activity of just viewing something and just doing nothing. You want us to be engaged. So, Lord, help us to be engaged. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for the example of Jesus. Who was more active than Jesus? He was on the move all the time, doing your will. Help us, Lord, to be actively doing your will. And may you work in us, Lord, and may we allow you to do that work. May we work with you, although all the credit is yours and not ours. Thank you for hearing our prayer, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Not a bad thing in the Bible for your salvation to be worked out. If you inhibit it, it's not going to happen, but God wants to do it, and he's glad to do it. May he do his will. May he accomplish his will in you today. We are thankful for that. God bless you today.